Hello students, good morning. Here is Harish Yadav from St. Paul Senior Secondary School, Etah. I am going to teach you English literature. Today's topic is class 8, chapter 14. Chapter 14, poem. It is a poem, How the Little Kite Learned to Fly. First of all, let us see few word meanings. Graver here means more determined. Thrilled, excited. Stirred, moved. Trembling, shaking. Whirling, moving round and round. Tranquil, peaceful. So, here is a poem which is an inspiring poem. The theme of the poem is inspiring. And through this poem, the poet wants to inspire and encourage the children to do something nice, to try and try again, to make good efforts to achieve something in their life. Students, you all know that most of the times you are afraid of doing something, and then afterwards you do those things. But two things: first of all, being afraid, and then doing the same thing very easily. There is a gap in between which is filled by sometimes your parents, your grandparents, your friends, your teachers, and there are so many people who help you to do certain thing, means to inspire you, to encourage you, to motivate you so that you could do those things easily. The things which you are being afraid to do. So, you might have heard stories from your grandparents that they are telling stories to you most of the times. And always, if you see their stories, there is some theme or there is some message hidden behind their stories. Those stories always inspires you. These stories always motivate you to do something better, to do something nice. If you have heard the name Shivaji, he was a great personality of Indian history. He has defeated Mughals and Britishers. In 16th century, he has established the great empire of Maharashtra. And this state was so strong that it had not allowed any foreigner to capture that area. So, if you want to know the history of Shivaji, actually Shivaji, in the age of 11, first time he won the battle, and this thing was written in golden words in our history. An 11 years boy who have won the war. But this is not because he was strong, but there is a thing behind that also. His mother Jija Mata, who has encouraged him always from his childhood. She has taught him the stories of Ramayana and Mahabharata. She has encouraged him, motivated him to be strong and courageous, to fight his enemies. And there were some people, his you can say assistant or his helpers, who have taught him the skills of fighting. Means there is someone who always teaches you, motivates you, and you can do the things which seems to be very difficult. If anyone asks you that you should, if anyone tells you to score 100% marks in your exam, you will get afraid as soon as you hear this thing. But there are people, before few days I heard in news that in Madhya Pradesh 10 to 15 students, 15 toppers, they got 100% marks. Means not only one but 15 students, they got 100% marks in their board exam. So if anyone asks you to score 100% marks, it is not a difficult thing, but you can do it easily. If someone asks you, if someone encourages you, if someone inspires you, you will be able to do it easily. So, Let us see, let us read this poem. What is there in this poem? Who is inspiring? Who has got inspired? If you see the title of the poem, How the Little Kite Learned to Fly, means here the title is telling that someone is learning something, means little kite. Little kite here means a small baby, you can say. A person who is very innocent. And if he is learning anything first time, means child. Here, this little kite, it refers to child here who is trying to learn something. How the little kite learned to fly means what are the situations and how one can learn something, that you will read in this poem. Let us begin. I never can do it, the little kite said. First line, you know, what do you read in the first line? I never can do it means impossible. Every person, every innocent person, every child thinks that he can't do. He can't get 100% marks. Even the child who is first taken to class nursery, he thinks that no, he will not able to go to school because he cannot leave his mother, he cannot leave the home. And how he will remain there for 5 to 6 hours, leaving his parents or family behind. So, I never can do it, the little kite said, as he looked at the others high over his head. When this kite, little kite, saw the other kites flying high in the sky, it thinks, it comes to his mind, it is the voice of his heart that I can never do it. It is impossible to do this thing. I never can do it, the little kite said, as he looked at the others high over his head. I know I should fall if I tried to fly. Now, the thing that comes in the mind of the child or anyone, the same thing is written here. The kite thinks that I know I should fall if I try to fly. It means fear. There is a fear in the heart of that little kite that he will fall if he tried to fly. Try, said the big kite, only try. And the big kite means elder one. They always motivate that try, try, try and try. You will succeed one day if you try. Try, said the big kite, only try. Or I fear you never will learn at all. Because if you will not throw away the fear, you will not able to do anything. Means you will not able to fly if you don't keep away your fear. But the little kite said, I am afraid I will fall. So there is a fear inside, and the kite said that he is afraid that he will fall, and he don't try because of that fear. So, the first stanza, I never can do it, the little kite said, as he looked at the others high over his head. So, said, head, fly, try, all, fall. The last words of these lines, they give some rhyme. So, the rhyming words are said, head, fly, try, all, fall. Now, do you understand the first stanza? It is the beginning stage of any learner, you can say, or the beginning stage of child. The child is always fearful. It has fear inside his heart that everything is impossible. Whatever things they see new, they feel that it is impossible to do that thing. Now, and the elder ones, they are motivating, they are encouraging, they are teaching them that they should try. They will learn. Unless they try, they will not able to learn anything. See, second stanza. The big kite nodded. Ah, well, goodbye. Nodded means to move head in affirmation. The big kite nodded. Ah, well, goodbye. I'm off. And he rose towards the tranquil sky. Tranquil here, peaceful sky. The sky is called peaceful here, and in that peaceful sky the big kite rose high and high up, and it wished goodbye to the small kite. Means here, the elders, if they want to, one more thing, one more message that is given here, that elders should do first whatever things they want to teach the younger ones. They should do it first. They should set an example in front of them so that it will make easier for the youngers to learn. Only if I give speech and lectures, it will not help the person to learn. But if I do myself whatever thing I want to teach other, that will help them easily. The same thing Gandhiji did. Mahatma Gandhi, if you remember, whatever Mahatma Gandhi wanted to teach Indians, he did it himself. If he wanted to teach Indians that they should use Swadeshi, they should make their own cloth and wear, he did the same. He wear his own made khadi dress and he taught them in this way. So the big kite nodded, "Ah well, goodbye, I'm off," and he rose towards the tranquil sky. Then the little kite's paper stirred at the sight, and trembling he shook himself free for flight. Now in third and fourth line, then the little kite's paper stirred at the sight. As soon as the little kite saw that big kite flying high, it stirred, its paper stirred means it got frightened. There was a trembling and shook himself, the trembling with fear and shook himself for flight. Means it had fear to fly. First whirling and frightened, then graver grew. So as soon as the little kite started its flight, it got trembled and had fear inside. It started whirling, means moving round and round upwards. And then graver grown, determined. And slowly it got determined that now it will fly. Whatever happens, it will fly now. And graver grown, up he rose through the air alone. And then slowly, alone, little kite alone started moving upwards in the sky. Till the big kite looking down could see the little one rising steadily. And the big kite saw down that the little kite is rising slowly up. So this second stanza tells us that after motivating, means when big kite himself started flying, after looking this, the little kite also got some courage and it started to try, and in his trial it started moving upwards. So this second stanza teaches us that unless we start anything, we cannot do it, we cannot finish. Only to finish, the thing is to start. If you start, you will surely finish. So now third stanza. Then how the little kite thrilled with pride. Now the little kite thrilled with pride means it got happy with pride, means it has pride in his heart that he has done the thing which seems to be very difficult. The little kite has now started flying because it seems to be very difficult, impossible to the little kite, and now it had started flying. So then how the little kite thrilled with pride. Thrill means excited, became happy with pride. As he sailed with the big kite side by side. Now this little kite is sailing, means flying side by side with that big kite. Means it has done, now he has done, the little kite has done the big job of flying like a big kite. Then how the little kite thrilled with pride as he sailed with the big kite side by side. While far below he could see the ground. Means when this little kite looked down, he saw the ground. Far below he saw the ground. While far below he could see the ground and the boys like small spots moving round. The boys who are standing on the ground, they look like small spot, means just a point. As we see the point, small point, this was the size of the boys who were below on the ground, means it shows the height of the kites flying. The kites were flying at the very great height from where these boys, big boys, they were looking like a spot. They rested high in the quiet air, and these kites, they rested high, means they are flying continuously in the quiet sky. And only the birds and clouds were there. What? Who were the other companions for the little kite? Birds and clouds. They were also flying with this kite there in that quiet sky. Oh, how happy I am, the little kite cried. Now the little kite is happy and thrilled, and it cried that, oh, how happy I am. And the little kite felt happy. This is the main thing, main point to be noticed, that when you feel anything difficult, you got afraid inside and you are very fearful inside to do something. But as soon as you start and you finish the job, you become pride, you become happy, and then the thing which you complete gives you pleasure and happiness. The real happiness you get only after you finish the work. After you finish mostly the difficult work. So always try to do difficult work. Try to do that thing which seems to be impossible, because after doing that impossible thing, you will get the happiness, the most, you will become the most happiest person in the world after doing the most difficult job. So always try to do difficult job if you want to become more happy. If you want to become happiest person, you should do the difficult job. There is one proverb in English that no gain without pain. So students, if you didn't take any pain, if you didn't do any effort, you will not gain, you will not get the good results in your life. So to get happiness, to get good things in your life, you will have to surely do big efforts. That means you will gain everything only if you do pain, means if you do hard work. See, then last line, second last, oh, how happy I am, the little kite cried, and all because I was brave and tried. The reason for this happiness, the little kite is giving the reason for happiness, that it has shown courage and it has tried hard, means the courage and the bravery and hard working nature. Bravery and hard working, these two qualities of person, courageousness and hard working, will lead you success in everything in the life, and all the difficult things you can only get only if you try hard and have courage in yourself. So in this way, the last para, the last stanza of this poem, it gives you message that how a person feels after finishing the great and big jobs. It is a happiness, and that one gets only if one is courageous, brave, and if one tries hard, if one works hard, and if one do good efforts to do anything, then only you can get real happiness and real pleasure, and that is called the success in life. Success doesn't mean that you are earning thousands, lakhs, crores, millions, billions. Earning money is not a success, but success is getting pleasure, being happy from inside, and satisfaction. The satisfaction of heart, being happiness, means becoming happy is the real success in life. And this little kite has given you message that when you work hard, you get succeed, and the real success means becoming happy. So the poem is very inspiring poem. So students, you should get inspiration from your teachers, from your parents, everyone, and everything that you see, you should get inspiration from that. Even you can get inspiration from nature. If you have seen ant, a very little creature, ant. They try to climb wall, but they fall down. Once they fall, again they try to climb. Again they fall, third time they fall. And if they have to try 20 times, they try, but they climb at last. Means the small creature in the world also try hard to get success, to get happiness and to finish their work. So why can't you? Are you smaller than those ants? No. Are you weaker than those ants? No. It is the smallest creature, the weakest creature in the world. And when it can get success, when it do not leave, when it do not quit, but it tries hard and hard again and again, so why can't you? So I wish you all the best, that you should try hard and you get success. The time never stops for you, but the time will come for you when you get success, when you do something best. So in this way, this chapter is finished. In next video, you will get solutions or question answers of this chapter. By that time, goodbye. Have a good day. Thank you.